Hey everybody, I got a new wood burning kit. This is the first time that I've ever used it. And to break it in, I think I'm just going to write the names of states, United States states, on some popsicle sticks. We'll start with Alabama. Probably best known for the Alabama Crimson Tide. College football. And it's alphabetical, so the next one up is Alaska. It's probably best known for, bald eagles, dog sledding, glaciers, moose, northern lights, things like that. The next up is going to be, I need to make sure my popsicle stick is flat. It's going to be Arizona. That's probably best known for deserts and ghost towns and petrified wood. I don't like the way that came out, so I'm going to rewrite Arizona, see if I can do a better job. Writing in cursive with a wood burner is not, it's not that hard. It's okay. Now the next state I'm going to write is Arkansas. It's probably best known for the Clintons, like Bill and Hillary, and Hot Springs. I think the home of Walmart is in Arkansas. Now this state is California. It's probably best known for things like beaches and earthquakes. Hollywood. Back in the day, the gold rush. Yeah, I need to dot that I. Now this state is this is Colorado. I guess it's famous for things like gold mines and off-road driving and Rocky Mountains and things like that. Now this state is Connecticut, and I guess it's probably known for things like casinos and insurance companies, state parks, expensive state parks. Now this would be Delaware. And I guess Delaware is known for tax-free shopping or incorporating businesses. This state is Florida. You know, airboats and beaches and hurricanes, ocean piers, sunshine. Now we got Georgia, maybe best known for things like Peaches, Gone with the Wind, you know, the movie, Southern Hospitality. Now we're going to write Hawaii. Known for beaches and islands and luaus, snorkeling, I don't know, volcanoes, waterfalls, all sorts of stuff. This is going to be Idaho. Known for fly fishing and potatoes, rivers, scenic rivers, whitewater rafting. And next will be Illinois. A lot of people call it Illinois because there's an S on the end, but it's Illinois. You know, land of Lincoln, Chicago blues, corn dogs and deep dish pizza. And this is Indiana. It's known for corn and farms and some NASCAR. Covered bridges, I guess. Did I say NASCAR? I meant Indy racing. You know, Indy 500. So Iowa is known for corn also, and farms and politics. This would be Kansas. You know, we're not in Kansas anymore. It's known for, you know, sunflowers and wheat, you know, Wizard of Oz, prairies. And this would be Kentucky. What's Kentucky known for? Fried chicken, bourbon, whiskey, bluegrass, horse breeding, horse racing, you know, Kentucky Derby. This would be Louisiana. It's known for, you know, alligators and bayous and Cajun food, you know, gumbo, jazz. And I guess maybe riverboat casinos and shrimp. Yeah. Now, Maine, that's known for lighthouses and lobsters and log cabins and lumberjacks. And there's Maryland. Or Maryland. And it's known for, well, I guess, crab cakes and lacrosse. Kind of drawing a blank. I don't know of anything else it's known for. No disrespect. I'm sure it's known for a lot of things. I just don't know what they are. And this would be Massachusetts. It's known for things like pilgrims, great universities and colleges, cranberries, you know, New England clam chowder. They got some really good professional sports teams there. You know, Boston Celtics. Oh, and witches, too. I almost forgot. Witches. Now, this one's going to be Michigan. And they're known for things like Great Lakes, lighthouses, shipwrecks in the Great Lakes, fly fishing. Oh, Detroit, you know, automobile industry. And now we've got Minnesota. Yeah, they're known for things like, you know, the Minnesota Vikings NFL football team. And, you know, lumberjacks like Paul Bunyan. Lots of roadside attractions in Minnesota. Ice fishing. You know, good outdoorsy stuff. And you've got Mississippi. It's got a, you know, they got a lot of casinos in Mississippi and lots of cotton fields, and there's the birth, back in the day, you know, the Mississippi Delta blues sound, Robert Johnson and people like that. They got some good college teams there also. This is Missouri, or some people say Missouri. We got a lot of natural springs. And I guess they're known for ribs, barbecue, you know, wineries. Montana, it's known for, you know, cowboys and glaciers and grizzly bears, log cabins and ranches, and, oh, big skies, yeah. Montana's the one known for big skies. Nebraska. It's known for corn and of course college football. I'm sure there's other things going on there, but I'm not sure what. No disrespect. Now, Nevada is known for things like deserts and Art Bell, UFOs, aliens, you know, casinos, you know, Las Vegas. And then we've got New Hampshire. And what's that known for? Covered bridges, fall foliage, lakes. No sales tax, I don't think. And skiing, they got a ski thing going on there. Hiking and... I think there's a lot of moose. I think there's a lot of moose in New Hampshire. Now we're riding New Jersey. It's known for like boardwalks and casinos and gardens. New Jersey's a garden state, is it? Am I right on that? I think so. Like, some really nice amusement parks in New Jersey, too. Now, New Mexico, is it known for things like chili peppers and I think they do a lot of hot air balloon festivals or fly-ins or whatever they call those. Roswell, New Mexico, you know, UFOs, you know, aliens. A lot of Southwestern art scene going on there. And we've got New York. That's known for things like, obviously, New York City, the Big Apple. You know, pizzas and skyscrapers and theater and museums. And you got the Glens. Oh. Wineries. I need a flat side. Sometimes these sticks aren't perfectly flat. So this is going to be North Carolina. It's known for, you know, barbecue and furniture and tobacco. Whitewater rafting. I've been whitewater rafting in North Carolina before. They got some nice beaches. And, you know, they got a lot of pig farms in North Carolina. And, of course, they're known for college basketball. And then there's North Dakota. You know, they got the Badlands and, you know, the oil boom, you know, fracking. And I think a lot of coal comes out of North Dakota. You know, I've got this thing turned all the way up on high to be able to burn this hard popsicle stick wood. There's Ohio, you know, covered bridges and Dutch Amish country. This is Oklahoma. Yeah, they got a lot of casinos there and some good college football and Native American culture. I think Route 66, or some people call it Route 66, goes through Oklahoma. Then you've got Oregon. Lots of, pubs, microbreweries, and, waterfalls. And they got whitewater rafting and stuff like that there. This would be Pennsylvania. What's that known for? Pennsylvania is known for things like coal mining and covered bridges and pretzels, the Hershey chocolate factory. And I think there's a large Dutch Amish culture there also. And shoe fly pie. In Pennsylvania. And this one is Rhode Island. I guess Rhode Island is mostly famous for being the smallest state. It's not very big. But they do have a lot of mansions and miles of coastline. A lot of sailing takes place right off on those waters. And you got South Carolina. That's known for things like, grits, golfing, boiled peanuts. I'm kind of drawing a blank. I'm trying to think of other things it's known for. I'm sure there's a lot. I can't think of anything at the moment. As soon as I move on to another popsicle stick, I'll probably think of something. Now, South Dakota. They've got some badlands also. And, the Black Hills. A lot of gold mines. Or they used to be. I guess there still are, I don't know. This is going to be Tennessee, the home of Elvis Presley, rest in peace. Live music, especially country music, Jack Daniel's whiskey, and a pretty good college football team, I guess. Nashville is where they had that big bomb go off in front of the AT&T office a few weeks ago. Now, Texas is known for, you know, football and cowboys and rodeos and things like that. In Utah, ATVing, you know, four-wheeling, you know, outdoor recreation, things like that, skiing. Vermont has a lot of breweries, and they're also known for their cheese, almost as much as Wisconsin. Fall foliage and maple syrup, yeah. Vermont. Now, Virginia, they're known for, I don't know, tobacco, wineries, apples, you know, apple orchards. It's kind of like the, I don't know, a lot of presidents, I think, came from Virginia. Oh, Civil War battlefields, Virginia, I almost forgot. Now, Washington, they're also known for apples and grunge rock. Grunge rock, rain, rainforest, volcanoes. I don't know what else. Mountains with glaciers and cherries and other stuff. West Virginia. It's known for, let's see, coal mining. They got some good whitewater rafting there also. A lot of good hiking. Yeah, West Virginia. And my home state of Wisconsin, known for beer, Green Bay Packers, bratwurst, fish fries, you know, Milwaukee Brewers, you know, it's pretty cool. Wyoming is what's Wyoming known for? Grizzly bears, I think. Ranches. A lot of hot springs, you know, geysers in Wyoming. A lot of cowboys. That's pretty much it. I appreciate you watching. See you next time.